In this tutorial, I'll show you how to tilt a curve. Let's go to Edit Mode, and type M to merge the vertices at the center. Type E to extrude, and add a skin modifier. What if we wanted to somehow rotate or scale a vertex to change the shape of the mesh? Would that work? That's not going to work. We'll have to apply the modifier first, in order to select and modify the faces we want to rotate. But we can scale the mesh under the skin modifier setting by pressing Ctrl A. Let's remove the mesh, and create a curve point. If you don't see the point in the menu, please activate an extra objects add-on. I'll type A, V, as in Victor, and A, to smooth the curve. Unlike the vertex with a skin modifier applied, we can freely scale a curve point. However, the shortcut is not Ctrl A. It's Alt S. I'm using a proportional editing feature to affect other curve points as well. Since we can't see the end result of tilting a curve by using a round bevel, we need to add a rectangular curve as the curve's bevel object. The shortcut is not R. It's Ctrl T after selecting a curve point in edit mode. Do you remember how I was using a proportional editing? We need to turn that off, because the tile feature has got its own. My old mouse's left button is not clicking again. There we go, it's working now. Unlike the normal proportional editing, we can adjust the affected region by using a built-in feature like this. I'll create a sphere, use the curve object as its child object, and instant the curve object in the faces. By the way, we must convert the curve object to mesh first. The tentacles look weird, because the curve object was not centered to the world center properly. Let's fix that. Let's select the curve mesh, go to Edit Mode, move it, rotate it, go to Object Mode, and move the origin to the 3D cursor. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.